Hello, everyone, and welcome to the finals of the 2017 Mustafar Open. I'm Zach.
And I'm Steven.
And on the left here, we have Mark Sebo from the 512th Squadron podcast from Austin.
From Austin. He's a Texas guy, as you might expect, Jeremy Chambly playing on the right. And he's a Kessel Run podcast guy from Frisco, Texas.
The old podcast.
So off. I imagine these guys have played before.
Yeah, they seem to know each other. This event was in San Antonio in January of 2017. So they were really friendly. I was there. I've had the fortune of playing and losing to both of these players. So on the left, Mark running Imperial. I was very happy to see this list because not only was it Imperial, which I was excited about, but it was just the weirdest Imperial list I've seen in a very long time. So we'll start from the top. As they're placing their ships, they've already placed the rocks, which you can see. We have Quick Draw McGraw.
Is that it, right? That's the X-Wing's so good at names. The community does such a good job with this.
Yeah, I remember asking Alex Davey about what this was, and it was just like, raises hands, doesn't know where this is from. Anyways, Quick Draw Ty SF making the finals here, which is great. Classic, never seen the ship in a cut before. This ship in a cut before. Two attack, two agility, of course, three health, three shields. Couple upgrades here. Special Ops Training, when it's attacking out of its primary, it can add an attack die. If it does not, it gets an auxiliary shot out of the back arc. Also has Fire Control System. After it shoots, it gets a target lock on
makes
the ship.
Makes sense, yeah.
Also has the new Lightweight Frame from Wave 10.
Upgraded.
Which is an incredible card. Basically, you get an extra agility so long as your opponent is rolling additional attack dice than you. So if they're rolling three and you're rolling two agility, you get to roll an extra die in, which
that's
is really
sweet. So basically anything with three dice or more attack and quick draw, you get three agility.
That's right.
That's really sweet.
And you can't equip that unless you have two agility or less. So
that's
a nice little balance there. And Expertise, another Wave 10 card. All of your attack dice showing focus just get turned to hits.
So it's like a permanent. Yeah, it's like a permanent focus effect. That's pretty incredible.
Yep, and Quick Draw's ability, of course, when they lose a shield, you get to make a primary attack. So potentially up to three extra attacks throughout the game. Unlikely,
that's wild.
But possible.
That's why they call you Quick Draw.
That's right. And of course, we have Colonel Vesser here on the TIE Defender. Anytime he attacks, if the defender has a target lock on them, you get a free target lock after you roll your dice. Super powerful, especially, of course, with Quick Draw, who's got the Fire Control System, getting the free target locks on these enemies.
That makes sense.
Ty D, minus 2 points, gets an evade token if it takes a three or more.
It's pretty tiny.
Ty Mark II, going to get the green banks across the board. Tractor Beam, hilarious include here, nice little cannon, potential to really just reduce their agility across the board.
And move them around, even.
And that's really potent with Quick Draw, who can shoot after Vessery with his ability triggering on the thing. And of course,
I'm seeing a lot of
again.
Synergy here, Zach.
Synergy
like
is
these
the
guys
name
have some synergy going
of the
on.
X-Wing game. When you're 10 waves in, there better be synergy.
There better be synergy.
Say.
That's right.
Expertise, of course, changing all of his hits to or eyeballs on offense to hits, which means again he can save that focus for defense. And finally, rounding out, we have Pierce Sabacc, TIE Striker. Just great. I love
seeing these. Look at these lists.
Just all the non-standards.
I'll
right?
get you. Yeah. Run this down, and then we got to
so
talk about this.
Pierce Sabacc gets an extra attack dice as long as it only has one or less damage, meaning that initial engagement. Range three.
It's only got four health too, so like that's going to be a lot of the game.
That's right. And adaptive ailerons, before it reveals its maneuver, it has to take a one forward or bank. And of course, trick shot has no idea what that does.
I'll tell you what it does.
Oh, extra dice is obstructed.
Anytime it's obstructed, there's the thing.
Man.
Now, I think this is important actually to know. I'm just standing here, and I actually, you know, I looked up some things beforehand. Zach's doing this all from memory. You know why? Because you were down in San Antonio, and you had it. So what's it like? I mean, you have to approach these lists. Obviously, I don't think, did you expect, like, to come up against Quick Draw, Vessery, Sabacc kind of thing? Or are you reading the cards? You, like, before the game?
I had to read the cards. So I'm playing Mark in the top eight, and I had to just go across, and it's rare, but you go across the table, and she's like, what do these cards do?
What are you doing, Mark?
And, you know, because Expertise and the TIE Striker and the Lightweight Frame are very new cards in general. But then Quick Draw and Pure Sabacc, Quick Draw has been around a while. You just don't see him.
Yeah.
So you have to read the Special Ops Train. You have to read, and it's just like, how does this work?
Yeah.
And you have to be careful how your list is going to even approach that, because you can't give them too many attacks.
Because surely Mark knows exactly how it works. So that's a cool advantage coming in. And it makes a lot of sense to run these kinds of, like, wild card lists if your opponent doesn't know what you're doing and you have this beautiful synergy that is kind of hidden underneath the layers. Then pretty soon, it's like halfway through the game, it's like, oh no, I played this completely wrong.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Jeremy over on the other side.
Very
like I said, Kessel Run podcast. So check that out. That's posted on Team Covenant, our website, quite often. So you can find that there. And then just running down a scum list. Zach, can you do it for me? Can you give me the love here?
So starting with the top here, as Jeremy would call him, Fun Rao. The Protectorist Starfire.
Jeremy's a wild man.
I looked back at our unboxing of him, and it's funny because I had no idea he was from Rebels, even though I was watching, and I connected the dots. He's just a big character in that. Anyways, so this is the Mind Link list. That is the card that unites this whole thing, okay. Which is anytime one of these ships, they all have Mind Link, anytime one of them would receive a stress or a focus, if any other ship in the squad doesn't also have that token, they have to get that token as well. Okay. So it's a way to be really efficient and get a lot of focus on all of your guys, but at the same time you risk if your opponent can give you stress or if you need to K-turn with one of these ships, all of your other ships get that. And there's a lot of synergies we have to run through here.
I like that a lot.
So Fin Rao gets an extra dice when he's at range one, both offense and defense.
All right,
so if
no
you're shooting
deal.
Him at range one, he gets an extra agility. If he's shooting you at range one, he gets an extra attack dice. That can be a lot of dice.
All right.
He has auto thrusters, so if you're shooting him at range three or outside your primary arcs, he's going to get a turn a blank to an evade. He has Mind Link, of course, and his Concord Dawn Protector. So if you
love all of those words, to be honest.
Yeah, Concord Dawn Protector. If you have your opponent, if your opponent's shooting you at range one and you also have them an arc,
yeah,
you get a free evade token on that roll.
Okay. And you have to be at range one as well. Basically, you kind of have to be like pointed at each other. Yeah, yeah.
And so basically that ship is really good at being at range one because he gets the extra die on offense and defense and a free evade on defense if he's facing you. So he definitely can finish off a high agility ship here. So we have Asajj Ventress, which is the second ship here on the Shadowcaster. Great to see. Mind Link, of course. Her ability can give us enemy ship inside her, whatever that arc is called.
The mobile arc.
Mobile Fire Arc at range 1 to 2, a stress token.
Okay. So you got to point your arc at him, and then you can give him a stress. Hold on. We got dice rolling here. We better check that out.
Pure Sabacc rolling hits.
Yeah,
and then,
rolling hits, but all evades on the
other
side. No,
that was actually
right?
Backwards. So Manaru was shooting range 3. And rolled all hits, then Pure Sabacc just evaded it straight up. Which is a big deal because if it takes 2 damage, that gets turned down.
Wow. All right. Woo.
Anyways, so going down, Last Razi can remove a stress from any ship at range 2, get a free evade. Manaru can pass tokens. The synergy there is that if she passes a focus off and doesn't have a focus, she gets a focus back.
She gets it right back. Beautiful. Ooh, we got dice in different area codes here. 3 hits looks like coming through.
And 3 evades. 3 evades. So right, Sabacc was shooting back there at Manaru. All right, so now we've engaged. This is going to be really the primary engagement here.
I got to tell you, I love those templates. I think this is one of the most exciting looking matchups that I've seen in a long time. Hold on, we got 2 hits here.
And this is coming from the Shadowcaster?
Looks like he got evaded.
Man, that could have... So what Mark does with this list is he gets Pure Sabacc in range, right?
Yeah.
And I think he was too in range there. He was in range of too many ships. He could have just lost Sabacc there.
Yeah, that would have been a bummer. Yeah.
But he didn't.
And man, now, these guys now are having a great time. We're going to crank the audio on this one. All right, so you see the Mind Link there. So we had the focus come down here, and you see all those ships get focused.
And this is what's crazy. Mark is using Adaptive Airlines because he has to. He's boosting here with Pure Sabacc. He's going to land on a rock. He could take a damage. He might not. Let's see what he does. Nope, no damage.
No damage.
Now he does his maneuver. This is crazy maneuverability.
Whoa.
And this is, he just gets places. So he's turning, and this is crazy because...
I could have sworn you couldn't boost onto a rock like that.
Adaptive Ailerons has you do a maneuver.
Oh, it's not a maneuver. It's not a boost,
You maneuver.
That's
important.
So you can
do some wild things. You can even bump off of that, right?
Oh, man. How cool is this?
So he's in this crazy position. If Finn
decides... Look at this dogfight happening right here. Look at Finn right in the middle. Oh, yeah. Sabacc right there in the middle.
And he is barrel rolling to the right. So I think he is assuming Fin Rao is going to go forward.
Yeah.
Which is a crazy risk, because if Fin Rao turns towards Pure Sabacc here and doesn't bomb...
And just blows him up.
That could just be a dead ship, because he's also at range 1 of Manaru here.
All right, so coming in... Look at this. This is a classic X-Wing from Zach. I love seeing
this. Yeah, they're
games.
Just going after it. And Pure Sabacc, I'm not sure if he has... Oh, shoot, Shadowcaster. Pure Sabacc in trouble.
This is not good.
So if Pure Sabacc, though, has Manaru in arc...
Yeah.
Then that's actually a really big attack.
Yeah. Yep. Okay. And this is so...
That could be a 5-die attack. That actually, is a ton of damage. And Pure Sabacc is pretty cheap. I mean, I think at this... we're looking at like a 22-point ship. So if that gets 5 damage and soaks all of your opponent's round 1 attacks, totally fine. No one cares.
Fascinating.
All right, here...
This is where the money's happening, okay? Can you keep up with this for me?
Oh, shoot.
No.
If he had stayed where he was, that would be a bump. And Fin Rao would have none shots.
That is a real bummer.
Crazy.
So we can assume that...
Oh, and he's target locking.
Sabacc's not going to have a good day here.
Well, Fin Rao's going to be rolling a million dice. and everything is going to be really
nice. Yeah, no
really
big deal,
nice.
You know?
What's so, Jeremy there checking, I think, range, giving a stress to Pierce Sabak because he can. I think... Smash, here comes five. Target locking. Rerolling it. Focus, five hits. This could be the end of Sabak right
yeah,
here.
Yeah, actually, yeah, every reason to be the end of
and
Sabak.
And Sabak barreled, so no focus here.
Your god has left you. Where is your god now?
And it's gone. And it's just gone. Welcome to Maneuver City.
And that is such a, like, you can imagine, right? If he literally had just focused instead of barrel rolling, Finrod bumps, doesn't get a shot on Pierce Sabak. Sabak gets a shot at the Shadowcaster. That's a huge swing.
So this is a huge swing.
Yep. Range one here from Quick Draw. Looks like three hits. Two
oh,
evades.
Just
wow.
Rolls them bones.
So here's the thing, though, right? If Manaru shoots one at range one at Quick Draw, does one damage. Quick Draw gets to shoot right back.
Mm-hmm.
Right off of that ability. Now it has a target lock.
Is it worth it?
And it has expertise. So target lock, basically target lock focus. That's crazy.
Oof. Dead dice there.
Just one on the defender evaded.
Oh, and Jeremy just covering it all up. And ooh, that's a much better attack. Looks like one evade only. Manaru takes some damage. Decent chunk of damage there, to be honest. Pretty impressive. And so now, what, Asajj looking around here.
Here come the attacks.
Shooting on. And ooh, are those all blanks? We got one that goes to evade there. Man, lightning round here on the X-Wing tables.
Pierce Sabak just got aced.
Yeah, I'm still recovering, honestly. Still recovering. And Besser ends the turn. Looks like taking a damage. And we're back to the dials. Maneuver is happening. Just hyper speed. Going on a jump. And takes the focus there. Of course, everything else already has a focus. Keeping it. Getting it. And now Defender moving in. Vessery making it happen. And looks like in actually a similar position as Sabak, this could also kind of go poorly. Of course, where these ships end up.
So, and you can tell, so Manaru at half gone. If Sabak didn't just get wasted there.
Yeah, that's a real potential to just swing the game the other direction. Defender looking. They say it's all right.
Not bad.
Slips right in there.
And you really want to bump here. We'll see if it fits. That's going to be tight.
That's a fit. No.
I think the ships are in the way.
Yeah, that might be Bump City, maybe.
I think he fits, man. If it fits, it ships. It fits. That is actually not great. That is not great for Mark. Because Colonel Vessery down a shield. Now going to... Manaru has a range one on him.
Oh, no.
Asajj has a range one. Going to be able to give him a stress so she gets that free evade. And we'll see if old Quick Draw McGraw makes it through.
Get through there. The Thai Special Forces. Cool.
Probably
concept.
Better than anything, just that bump there. Oh, man, he called it.
Oh, nice.
Called and a lack of bump. Just going to hop on the other side of Asajj.
And just escapes.
And potential, honestly, because he's got that back arc now, right?
Yeah.
Which is great. So
that's how you fly the back arc.
Depending
right
on what Finrod does.
Just put him anywhere, guys. Put him anywhere.
Just put it anywhere. It's not like this is the finals of a major event. But depending on what Finrod does, if Finn like turns south, Quick Draw has a shot on him uncontested.
That would be wicked.
And then if you shoot Quick Draw, which you won't, he's just gonna get free shots. We'll see what he does here.
Looks like the old dial reveal and then dial cover up. I think the action still determining which action to take here. And gonna take focus. And yeah, well see, there it is, right? So now
that's good stuff.
Now it looks like a really good position for Quick Draw there.
Just imagine. I know we don't want to keep imagining the...
I can't even imagine it already. I've already stopped imagining it. There is no Pierce Sabak.
There is no Pierce Sabak.
There is nothing...
If Pierce Sabak hadn't been so risky a business...
Mark didn't get here not being risky, you know?
It's true. Could have paid off huge. If Finn had done like a three bank and bumped, I would have been singing a different song.
That's true. So true. That's why, you know what, at its heart, and this is why I think I like seeing this style of game, it is still very much a game of maneuvers. It's a game of calling that dial, figuring out where your opponent's ships are going to be, and sometimes just taking a chance, because obviously you can't always just know what they're going to do.
Absolutely.
Especially if Paul Heaver keeps making cards.
Yeah, I know. Okay, like... so if I'm Mark here, right, you have Manaru down to hole. If you can get rid of Manaru, you get rid of a ton of action economy. So I think both Sabak and Vessery are going to be going... Sabak here taking the two die on Finn, may as well. Two hits.
No, just it just covers them up. Jeremy,
so now he gets a shot out of
thunder.
His auxiliary arc, right? Turns.
Does one,
taking one. And so this is...
And it's a crit, too.
Wow.
What'd we get?
It doesn't seem relevant.
It's like a ship crit.
They don't seem to care. All right, and the expertise paying off here, right? And I think expertise is it's 4 cost to turn all your focus to hits on attack. Only really effective if you have a way of getting lots of shots. So both of these ships here have multiple shots.
Yeah. Makes a lot of sense. Boy, I cannot see those
And you
guys.
See, so Defender here on Manor hit him with the tractor beam, making her -1 agility, and then gets a second shot because of the Tai D title.
And then the crit there. So we got 2 crits now on Manor.
Down to 2. And so you can this is kind of what this list does. You can see.
And here come the big dads, though. There's 4.
I think range damage. 1 on Vestry.
Oh, that's
3
evades,
taking 1.
Boom, boom, boom.
That is exactly what Mark needed here.
Tie Defender staying in the game. It's like doing a crit 2. And a hit. She's helping. We got a focus and a couple
taking
more damage.
Taking his last shield and a crit.
Yeah. And so Vestry still didn't leave that turn unscathed for sure.
And you can see, though, glimpses, right? So he hasn't touched Quick Draw. But the position Quick Draw puts you in is you don't want to shoot him.
Right.
So you kind of have to go after the other ships first. And then if you get down to 1-on-1 with Quick Draw, that's a lot of potential offense.
And Finra's over here getting out of town.
Yeah.
Just back forward.
Finra is such a problem.
Now, is the question now, can Vestry potentially get Manaru off the board next turn? Do you think that's possible?
Like this turn?
Is that the idea? Yeah, after all these maneuvers?
Yeah, I definitely think he can. And as you see here, he is moving to do so.
Yeah, looking to do it.
He's got a target lock. He's got expertise. So you immediately have pretty good shot of doing multiple damage. He's got the cannon as well. So if he can hit with a tractor beam, Manor only gets 1 agility. And then at that point, he just needs to be hit. With a target lock focus, he's in the 90 percentile.
All right, well, is he going to have arc? I mean,
Well, he could barrel roll here to get in front of Asajj, which I think would be a good play.
That would be nice.
Because he'll get a shoot. He'll shoot before Manaru.
Yeah.
So should be able to take Manaru off before just focusing.
Takes the focus.
Hmm.
Does he have him in arc right now?
He could have barrel rolled there.
Yeah, that does look good, doesn't it?
Yeah, because I think you can barrel roll, potentially get range 1, block, which means Asajj can't shoot or take an action, right? And you have just a really great shot of taking Manor off the board before she can shoot. No penalty. And turning here, curious.
You seem like you're second-guessing Mark quite a bit here.
Well, I don't
after
know.
After losing to him.
This is true. I also have a top-down view, and I haven't been playing for 18 hours across 2 days.
That's true. There are rules.
But in that particular maneuver there, he just turns so he doesn't have a shot.
Well, you know, maybe you gotta work to get back into this board.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because he's gonna be able to make a turn, get back in the action, still have a backward shot maybe on Finra as he comes in.
But I think ideally you're removing Manaru, right?
And yeah, you have to remove.
You're not gonna chase down Asajj. I almost like the idea that the Tai can turn now, Tai Defender, and if right now Quick Draw was facing Fin Rao, he's just getting free shots.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
And instead, he's getting shot at.
Gotta get ships on the board.
And this is the turn. The Asajj is giving us stress here. But if Asajj can actually ping Quick Draw has no shots.
Yeah, just sitting out there, floating around.
Here we go.
And this is our
target locking.
Vestry, right?
Yep.
So it looks like we've got 2 showing, deciding whether to focus this into hits.
Doesn't he have expert? Oh, he's stressed.
Yeah.
The stress means you can't trigger expertise while you're stressed.
Oh, no.
That's a tractor beam, though. So it hits. So he's -1 agility.
All right, we need hits.
Target locking? 3. There it is. Ace in the hole.
I think he's got to decide that there's a focus there. So he goes and focuses it for 3.
And gets rid of Manor.
But Manor's off the board.
Again, though, imagine.
Imagine if
he barrel rolled and he bumps. Of course, without the focus, and the bump means that Asajj can't trigger the arc to give you the stress either.
Yeah,
so
that's
true. Then your expertise is on. I think that's just a crazy strong play.
Jeremy is throwing complete fire onto this board.
Looks like he got 2 there, so Vestry gonna go. And
wow,
that's another,
if
that had been Bump City, it just doesn't even happen.
Boy, this is falling apart. I really wish right now that Quick Draw had a shot on Fin Rao.
Old Fun Rao.
Or Fun Rao. I always say Fin Rao because of Mum Rao from Thundercats.
Thunder.
Just a kid form. Well, this doesn't look good, does it?
It is not. Mark is way behind. Of course, quick draw, though, like I said, he's going to get a lot of shots. Just depending on how this gets structured. But my problem here,
we're about
right?
We're going to see Conqueror Dawn Protector do the magic here.
It's
right
true.
Now.
And that's where, if you look at position here, Finn can easily move and then barrel roll to just not even be in arc. Oh, put it anywhere.
Just put it anywhere there.
But he can barrel roll right out of arc, and he's just going to get a free range one shot, which is unhealthy. Unhealthy yeah. for a quick draw. May not even get a trigger quick draw's ability at all. But again, you can see Mark's list, what it is capable of doing.
Yeah.
In that there are these turns where it just unloads damage on you.
I like it. Oh, man. Look at just
yeah.
Four. Madness.
Let's see what we roll.
Madness. Blank City is almost dead city here, huh?
All right. Gonna focus. Only take one. And wow, again, cool. with that lightweight frame, rolling an extra in, has the focus token. You can imagine, he gets two or three extra shots when he's losing those shields, and that is a lot of extra attacks.
Look at Finn just winning that exchange, though. One damage, unanswered.
Yeah. In an ideal situation, right, though, those two or three extra attacks with expertise to change your focus into hits and target locks with fire control
yeah,
system.
Yeah, you can see how it would really start to blow up.
Yeah, against a low agility ship like the Ghost, you can imagine it being a problem.
Yeah, which is what you were running, right?
It is. It
contrary
sure is.
To your better judgment and your personal preference.
Yeah, well, Imperial City, here I come.
Yeah,
you have to die a Jedi on Mustafar to come back as Sith Lord. That was my... I set
that was
it up.
Your plan all along,
yeah.
Huh?
I'll return
oh,
on Hoth.
Man. It's really good.
It's a real. Funny. It's better than I want it to be.
It's been yeah. He's out of town. Look at him just staying side arcing here on against quick draw, not giving him a chance to use any of those arcs.
Just none. None city.
None
I think
chances.
We're out of range here, so we'll go back to dials. And again, what Finn wants obviously is to be able to get the focus token from Asajj, and then barrel roll out of the arc of this TIE SF, which he should be able to do pretty effectively since he has initiative.
Finn looks so. So good. Or I love the look of that ship.
Oh, Finrod's great, man. He's the talk of the town right now.
Funrod.
Any time you can potentially roll five dice.
Yeah. Everyone pays attention.
Yes.
Every time.
All right, now he's turning, or he's banking.
Okay, so we saw the...
Oh, no, slooping.
Ah,
slooping ain't easy.
So that was the... What was that? That's the... Is that special ops training that allows him to do that? I can't remember. Was that the...
To do what?
You take a... Is he the one that can take a movement before he takes
no,
his...
No, that was adaptive ailerons. I'm curious about.
Okay.
He just took a sloop as his maneuver all so right. he can be facing the enemy ships.
So we were back to it. I yeah. missed an entire segment there.
Well, put it anywhere.
This is how we play down in Texas, boys?
That's right. Loosey-goosey. It's a joke in Tulsa. Put it anywhere. It's just bad. Because you bump. It's impossible not to. Especially the ships that just get huge.
Yeah.
All right. Looking like a tour.
Evaded.
Auto thrusters. He was shooting old Finrow. Curious choice.
All right. Well, I mean, is that your best chance to get something off the board?
I think it's your best chance to get a target lock. So that when you take this inevitable damage here, which you do, there go the shields. So he's going to get a shoot back here. He's got a target lock. Going to use it.
Is there anything written on those dice?
Looking
really?
At three, yeah.
Is there anything on there?
Those are the promo dice.
Am I just missing it?
And got him.
Oh, so many evades, you wouldn't even believe it.
Auto thrusters just making the magic happen. Focus here with Asajj. This is looking
oh,
real bad.
Good game city.
Looks like he got two damage there.
Oh, man.
Or one. Down to two health. No more shields. Doesn't get to trigger the ability. And Jeremy here just looking for a trip to Orlando. What are you going to do next, Jeremy?
I'm going
to Disney World. That's really what he's doing.
So is that to explain this open series concept, right? So there's a bunch of tournaments going on around the country slash world, right?
Yeah, there's eight tournaments. This year there's four in the U.S. The winner of each tournament gets flown to Orlando, Florida to play in the Coruscant Open, the finals of eight really obviously excellent players. FFG has yet to announce the very apparently cool and exciting format. They've said
okay.
It's going to be different.
A different
and
format once you get there.
Eight players show up, they play in a tournament, and the winner gets to be the Open Series champion, gets his Atlanta card. But of course, all eight people get flight and hotel. And
that's
a bunch
where
of cool
the money,
prizes.
I mean,
yeah.
That's killer. You get a free flight to Orlando for Star Wars
for
something.
For Star Wars
right?
Celebration, Star yeah, celebration. The annual just huge Star Wars
you can't
party.
Even get a ticket if you want in these days, right?
That's right.
Sells out super fast.
So that's what this whole thing is. And this was the first Open Series of the 2017 season. Now, what's cool, too, is that this is right before we had the Rogue One ships come out. But Wave 10 literally released in the following week. So the game is about to just completely blow up.
Boom, look at this.
Getting some damage in.
Three damage. Don't think it's going to matter terribly much, but you know what? We'll take it.
Hey.
We will take it.
All right, he is rocking and rolling here. All the damage. Is he gone? There you have it.
That's
it. Huge congrats to Jeremy. Both these players are excellent. These lists were incredible. I love seeing this kind of diversity in the meta right now.
I mean, this is a great game of X-Wing. I mean, I feel like I haven't really seen something like this at a top table in a while. We've seen these big, dumb ships moving around.
Well, I think the top eight breakdown was 3 Imperial, 3 Scum, and 2 Rebel.
Nice.
Which is fantastic. And very
well
different.
Done.
There was Ghost Biggs, obviously, the Rebels. It was like missile Rebel, like bomb swarm with headhunters. You had Stress, you had a Palp Aces, you had Palp Defenders, you had this crazy Imperialist, and then you had a couple different Scum iterations, a lot of them, I think 2 of them were Mind Link. But an incredible state of X-Wing.
Beautiful stuff.
Only getting more exciting with Wave 10.
All right, so onward to Orlando. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll catch you potentially there. Who knows what's in the cards for us.
I'll be there.
Until then, just, well, keep playing.
See you guys.